Hello friends, welcome to GYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and currently we have started our MCQ series of environment and ecology, and currently we are on lecture number 14 of it. Already 13 lectures has been covered. So if you want to see those 13 lectures, you can go into the playlist of my channel. I have made a special playlist for this. And you can see all those videos, previous videos relating to MCQ series of environment and ecology. So friends, we will continue this series till 31st May 2019 because your prelims is scheduled on 2nd June 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So you can see that if we cover daily 5 questions, then by 31st May we will be covering 1100 to 1200 questions. So you can see that how much practice you will be doing before the exam if you follow this MCQ series daily. Friends, it is not the case that we will cover only environment and ecology. Other series will be started as well from December, but from December onwards, because these days we are a little bit busy. So from 2nd December onwards, we are going to start the topics, all other topics as well, like art and culture, history, polity, geography, economy, current affairs. All those topics will be covered. So let's start, friends, our discussion, our lecture number 14's discussion. The first question is relating to a grasshopper. The question is, the grasshopper population in prairies is limited in large part by the number of birds in the region. Full stop. Following a terrible storm that killed many of the birds, the grasshopper population exhibits exponential growth. Full stop. This happened because the grasshoppers experienced. So a kind of situation is given to you. So grasshopper population was earlier limited in prairies due to the existence of large number of birds, but after a storm, many birds were killed and the grasshopper population saw an exponential growth. So why this happened? The reason is asked for this. So A option is a new biotic potential with steady environmental resistance. B is a new biotic potential with decreased environmental resistance. C option is a steady biotic potential but decreased environmental resistance. D option is a decreased biotic potential and decreased environmental resistance. So friends, here the C statement is correct, a steady biotic potential but decreased environmental resistance. But friends, what happened? Why this option C? Because potential, biotic potential remained constant, only the environmental resistance decreased. So environmental resistance is kind of a resistance that limits the population of a particular species. So in that, multiple factors count, like extreme climate, natural disasters, or the predator population. If the predators are much and they are feeding on the prey, then prey population will remain constant, or it can be decreased. But as the birds that eat these grasshoppers, they died, so the predators died due to the storm, the environmental resistance decreased, but the biotic potential remained steady. So that's why your C option is correct regarding this question. So this is explanation here. Biotic potential is what urges a population to grow. So biotic potential urges population to grow in number. So it is a measure of how well a species can survive, including how well it is adapted to the environment and its rate of reproduction. Some species produce a lot very often, but they have to invest a very large amount of energy for raising and protecting them, while others produce fewer babies only. So while the biotic potential of a species causes the population to increase, the environmental resistance keeps it from increasing relentlessly. So certain species have very high biotic potential. They have very high reproductive rate, or they are very well adapted to the environment. So they have a very high biotic potential. They have a potential to survive, but due to environmental resistance, their population remains under control. So option C is correct. Why? Because environmental resistance are the factors like that contain the population of a particular organism from increasing endlessly. So they lower the chances of reproduction, affect the health, or raise the death rate in the population. So environmental resistance factors include factors that are abiotic or biotic, living or non-living. So biotic factors are things like predation, parasitism, lack of food, competition with other organisms, and disease. So in this case, what happened is the biotic factor decreased. So this is the predation. The predation decreased because the birds that feed on the grasshoppers, they die due to storm. So the predators decreased. So the grasshopper population increased. So that's why the option C is correct. The biotic potential was steady, but the environmental resistance increased. Why the biotic potential was steady? Because the reproduction rate remained the same, and also the adaptation is not immediate. It is a prolonged process to the environment. So there is no change in biotic potential, but a change in environmental resistance. Next comes the second question. A group of individuals of the same species that live and interact with each other in the same geographical area is called as. Friends, it is a very simple question. We have been asked that what we call the group of individuals that are of same species and that live in same geographical region and interact with each other. Friends, individuals of same species are called population. For example, human beings. Or then comes the community. Friends, community is a region which contains multiple populations. So there are multiple species. If multiple species reside in a region, then it is called community. So population is the kind of individuals of same species. So this is all about your second question or correction. Correct option is B. So population is group of individuals of same species inhabiting the same area functioning as a unit of biotic community in a specific time. So option C is also incorrect. Option D is also incorrect. To see the explanation in detail, you can read in PDF. Next is the third question. The keystone species are. What are the keystone species? We have been asked here keystone species. So you might have heard about it. It is a very important concept in your environment and ecology. Please listen to it carefully if you haven't read about this. The first statement is the most abundant species in the community. The second statement is carnivore as well as herbivore species. So we have to select the correct option from the below given options. So friends, here let me tell you that a keystone species can be carnivore can be a herbivore. So second statement is correct, but not the first statement. It is not necessary that the most abundant species in the community must be keystone species. Other species that may be less in number but that plays an important role in the ecological structure is called keystone species, and it is not necessary that the most abundant species is keystone species. So first statement is wrong. The second statement is correct. A carnivore as well as a herbivore can act as a keystone species. So option B is correct. So here is explanation about keystone species. What are keystone species? That play a critical role in maintaining the structure of an ecological community. So they have a great impact on the whole ecological community. So their impact is even greater than would be expected. So based on their numbers or based on their abundance, we kind of judge their impact. So but their impact in a real sense exceeds far greater than their relative abundance. So these are the keystone species which have a great role to play in ecological community in relation to their abundance or their biomass. So without the keystone species, if the keystone species are eliminated, the ecological community to which it belongs will be greatly altered. It would be greatly altered, and some species may also be negatively impacted. So keystone species have low functional redundancy. Friends, what does this mean? This means that if the species were to disappear, these keystone species were to disappear from the ecosystem, no other species would be able to fulfill its ecological niche. What are the ecological niche? It is a unique position enjoyed by a species in an ecosystem. So no other species will be able to meet its ecological niche without the keystone species. So ecosystem would be forced to radically change, allowing new or possibly invasive species to populate the habitat. So next is statement 1 is correct. It is not necessary that the most abundant species is the keystone species. There are not always the largest or most abundant species in an ecosystem. However, almost all examples of keystone species are animals that have a huge influence on food webs. So they play a huge influence on ecological structure, or we can say on the food webs. So the way these animals influence food webs varies from habitat to habitat. Statement 2 is correct, friends. Although predators are common keystone species, we almost see that the predators are the common keystone species, but in certain ecosystems there are herbivores also that play the role of a keystone species. For example, in Serengeti, friends, this is a geographical region in Africa. In this region, the elephants act as keystone species. How, friends? Because this is a grassland area, and these elephants, they feed on young saplings such as acacia, and then they kind that grow in the vast grasslands. So by eating these saplings, they prevent the growth of trees, and they prevent the conversion of that particular region into woodland. So they prevent the translation of they prevent the kind of transformation of the particular ecosystem. So regionally, by doing this, they help the other they help the grasses thrive, and they also other species such as wild beasts, zebras, antelopes. Without grasses, population of mice and shrews would be reduced. All these wild beasts, zebras and antelopes will also be affected. So in a way, by eating these saplings, elephants also play an important role. So elephants are herbivores, they are not carnivores. So it is not necessary that a carnivore must be a keystone species. The herbivore can also be a keystone species. Next question is, friends, fourth question: a population would be expected to grow in an ecosystem if. Here the question asked is that the population of a particular ecosystem will increase if. We have to see what will be the reasons that will cause the population of a particular ecosystem to grow. So first option is immigration increased and deaths and emigration decreased. So friends, by the first statement itself, you might have judged that this is the correct statement. But friends, in UPSC, I request you to please go through all the statements, not just read one statement and then mark it. It is sometimes the case that other statements are also correct, or sometimes the statement is very confusing. So you have to be very careful while attempting your exam. So here, immigration is what? Immigration is a kind of migration of external population to a particular region. So if there is an immigration taking place from here to here, then certainly the population will increase. And also, if the deaths decrease here, and also if the emigration, the outgoing population is decreased, then obviously the population will increase. So the A option is correct. Immigration increased and deaths and emigration is decreased causes the population to grow. Next, here is the explanation. I have already explained to you in detail what is this. So you have already judged that A option is correct. Next is fifth question. It is also based on a situation. The fifth question is, a squirrel population in Punjab region is limited by its eagle predators. The amount of acorns produced annually, nesting sites in the trees, and cold winter temperatures. So which of the following is an abiotic factor limiting this squirrel population? So friends, here is a kind of situation given to you that the squirrel, you know that squirrel population, it eats lot of acorns because the squirrels like acorns. It is a kind of food for these squirrels, as well as eagles are their predators, and nesting sites they reside in trees. So here the question is asked that the population is limited by its eagle predators, the amount of acorns that are also produced limitedly, and then nesting sites that are also limited because of the trees, limited trees, and also the because of the cold winter temperature. So we have to opt the abiotic factor out of these factors which are given, which are limiting its population. We have to choose the abiotic factor that is limiting this squirrel population. So friends, obviously I have already told you that there are certain factors that limit the population of a species, that these factors are biotic as well as abiotic. Biotic are related to are living factors, and abiotic are non living factors. So here, if you see what are the non living factors, only the cold winter temperature is the non living factor, that is abiotic factor limiting the squirrel population. So obviously the C option is correct, the stress of cold winter temperature. So correct option is C, because it is itself, I have not included the explanation of it because it is already self-explanatory that abiotic factor is the cold winter temperature. The eagles are biotic factor, they are predators, they eat their prey, that is squirrel. Also the acorns are the food, and it is a biotic factor which is limited in availability. If there are large number of acorns, then there are large number of squirrels. Also, if their nesting sites are high, because they live on trees, so trees are a kind of biotic factor. So their nesting sites are the biotic ones, that is trees. So if the trees are limited, their nesting sites are limited. So this is also a biotic factor. The only abiotic factor is cold winter temperature. So friends, this is all about today's lecture. If you liked it, please like it, please share it with your friends. If you have any suggestion, friends, for improvement, you can comment in the comment box. I will certainly appreciate your comment, your suggestion. Friends, lastly, if you want to subscribe to our Telegram channel, if you want to join us on Telegram channel, you can join it. I have provided the link in the description box. You can see the description box and you can join our Telegram channel, on which we regularly post all our initiatives that we are running on the YouTube. So in order to stay tuned, to remain tuned with us, to remain updated with us, you can join that Telegram channel, and there is no cost of joining that Telegram channel. In the last, friends, if you want to subscribe to these PDFs of these MCQs, you can WhatsApp us at this number 8968426481. So this is our WhatsApp number. If you want to subscribe to these PDFs of all MCQs that we are discussing on YouTube, you can WhatsApp us. So daily 5 questions are covered till 31st May. So you can see that we will be covering approximately 1100 to 1200 questions of this topic. So for the purpose of motivation, we have kept the minimal amount of fee, that is rupees 50. And for this is also affordable for you, because rupees 50 is for the entire course. You are not paying it for one PDF. By paying rupees 50, it is a single time payment. You will be subscribing to all the PDFs that we are going to cover till 31st May. So in a way, you will be getting 1100 questions in just rupees 50. So friends, you can subscribe to these PDFs by doing WhatsApp us at this number. So friends, why these PDFs are important? Because at the end of the day, in the last minute of the exam, you can't see the 15 to 20 minute long video. You must have some kind of notes or PDFs to revise the basic concepts. So in order to revise the basic concepts quickly and to be very much confident in your exam, you must have some kinds of handy notes in your hands, on your table, study table, so that you can quickly revise all your syllabus. So that's why these PDFs are important, and you must subscribe them if you want to be confident in your exams. The WhatsApp number is this for subscribing. Lastly, friends, we have made unofficial Telegram messenger, that is eSandesh. So this is our unofficial Telegram messenger that is available on App Store as well as on Google Play Store. So here if you want to join our Telegram channel, you can join our Telegram channel on this eSandesh also. So here is a search box. The link which I will be providing you to you in the description box about my Telegram channel, you can copy it and paste it here. And by pasting it here, you will get the link. You will get to my channel, and you can join that channel. So this is an app which is available on Play Store as well as on App Store. So thank you, friends.